When will we break the 1,000-kilometer range mark for an electric car?
As it is, the record right now for a Model S is 800 kilometers. That's the furthest that anyone has driven a Model S.
So we could be close?
Yeah, we're pretty close. Now, in order to do that, they did drive at a relatively slow speed. So, you know, we're talking, I think they drove maybe at 40 or 50 kilometers an hour or something like that. I think my guess is probably we could break 1,000 kilometers within a year or two.
Okay.
I'd say if you say 2017, I'd say 2017 for sure.
It is now mid-2017, and as far as we know, a Tesla has yet to do 1,000 kilometers. But they are getting close. Last month, Elon tweeted,
"Over 1,000 kilometers should be possible in a 100D with the right tires."
To show me what you want to change on the car.
Eric Lundgren, the guy who built the Phoenix, a car designed to do 400 miles on a single charge, has recruited me to see if we can hit the 1,000 kilometer mark.
This is the first look that anybody gets of the actual car. Nobody's seen this yet. You want to explain it?
So this is the controller, and this is made to run at 130 volts max, except this battery is 134 fully charged. So we just changed that to one that can handle more voltage, and then we can charge the battery all the way up. Just an extra 8 volts into the battery, it's like another 40 kilowatt hours worth of energy.
And to put it into perspective, so you know the BMW i3 car, we figured out how to calibrate this to get an extra, one and a half of those.
Yeah.
Whole car. So we can't wait to run this. We're gonna run it again in, we're gonna run this thing probably in a week.
Of course, that was easier said than done, because for the next week, we worked on the car around the clock, including international holiday like 4th of July.
Hey, Zach Ward.
Good night.
Thank you.
Very much, guys. Awesome. I really appreciate you.
Bye. Take care, guys. Thank you.
All right, and this is now where we start.
That's the new brake since the brake broke. I mean, this is some quality rattle can spray paint work here.
A little bit dirty.
Yeah, well, who cares what she looks like, man? She's gonna give us 600 miles.
Who cares what she looks like as long as she runs?
All right, let's go check out the film crew here.
Whoa, that's a big camera for this little car.
All right, it's 11:25 a.m. and we're about to take off. We're gonna try it and break the world record today. I added another 10 kilowatt hours worth of battery.
We just overcharged the battery. Are we ready? Let's do this, man, come on.
I'm not Catholic, but let's do it again.
He is going to run with slightly overcharged batteries. Not that bad. Each cell is about 4.2 something. It was like 136 volts on 32 cells. You guys, you do the math. What is that?
The plan is simple. Real world driving conditions starting in Bakersfield, California, all the way to Sacramento.
We know we're gonna go to the state capitol because we really wanna take a giant flag, wave it around the state capitol, drive around the state capitol, honk some horns and some air horns and make some noise, trying to get the government to realize that EVs are a real thing.
To keep my hands on myself. Think I'll dust them off, put them back up on the shelf. Kiss my little baby girl, there's a need. Got another mouth to feed.
If you want to put that on the outside of the car, is that going to affect the range at all?
Maybe. I mean, but we're not going to do it for 100 miles, right? We're just going to do it for
2.5 hours.
No, yeah, we're going to do it
for arriving at. It'd make for a really cool video, but then it's going to hurt the range. Kind of like, but you know what else hurts the range? We're going 70 now.
Yeah, we're going for it.
Even with a babysitter,
mama called the grave digger. We've traveled 150 miles so far, and we've used 296 amp hours so far in 150 miles, and it's at 127 volts. So my calculations say that we're using 250 watts per mile so far.
All right, ready to go?
Let's do it.
Before the sun goes down.
Get in, let's go.
See you there.
See you.
That means we barely tapped into this pack. That means as long as tomorrow goes like today, we're going to beat a world record. Not by a little bit, but we're going to set a world record that nobody's going to beat for a very, very long time. I think we're definitely going to hit 500, and I'm thinking we might. Just might. Just might hit 600 miles on a single charge. We got to go from here to go see Tesla.
All right, guys, in order to record, make sure that this is not connected to the night, we're putting a GoPro up here and a light, just so that everyone can verify that we didn't plug this car overnight. All right, good morning, guys. It's the next morning, and the Phoenix, after its 300 mile run last night, just sat in a parking lot throughout the night.
That's
ready here, whatever.
180.
Oh, that's 72.
Okay. So, 5 hours and 37 minutes of actual driving time, 51.42 miles per hour average.
Jacob!
How's it going?
Excellent. I've been following you for years.
Really?
On YouTube. I'm one of your subscribers.
Wow.
Always wanted to meet up with you, but you're in Southern California and I'm in Sacramento.
You're in Sacramento.
So, you know the difference.
Well, you just got your wish.
Figure out what's the best route,
which is I don't think any different than what we were coming up,
some of the mountains. Of course, Tesla was not expecting us, so they were having none of it. So we decided to get back on the road and go see Apple.
Are you making an Apple car? That's what I want to know. Because this guy that we're going to go talk to right now is working on a secret covert op project. One infinite loop. Alright, so we are currently at 450 miles. We're not done. We just took a brief stop here at Apple.
That's not a lot you can do in this car anymore.
We're gonna cheat.
There's a couple things.
I want it to be functional. Like, people were like, oh, take off the mirrors. Yeah, and I'm like, no, I want a car that's functional.
Right.
I want it, and like, oh, drive it on track. No, I want a car that gets from point A to point B, like people drive.
After 150 miles of driving on the second day, we decided to call it a night by leaving the car at Apple headquarters and setting up the cameras to record the night time lapse.
The best route, because every single one's just all like mountains that we gotta go through. There's no good route.
We have to plug you into the car when you get in.
Our average right now puts it at 615, without counting my overcharge.
So what does that mean?
He's trying to say we're okay, but I'm trying to tell him that we have not gone uphill for an entire day.
He's trying
ever.
To be positive, he's trying to be negative.
Yeah, pretty much. That's true. That's accurate.
Car's
ready. No, that's
ready.
Fine.
GoPros are rolling. Let's go see Tesla.
All right.
Okay. Let's do it. Now, we really just wanted to show Elon that he was right. 2017 would be the year 1,000 kilometers would be reached by an electric car. But as you can imagine, getting a hold of a billionaire is rather a hard thing. We talked to someone at Tesla, and they're a pretty cool guy, but we're pretty much being kicked out of here, so let's get out of here. human. 600 miles. Gentlemen, 1,000 kilometers. 1,000 kilometers.
All right, so this is Paso Robles. This is where we're staging there. 1,000 kilometers, because essentially that's where it actually did 1,000 kilometers. So it's not the most picturesque of towns, but this is where it happened. So
6:50 this morning. I told him, I'm like,
what are we at now? 6:30.
So 1,000 kilometers is impressive and all, but the battery still had energy left in it. So back on the road.
Yeah, the batteries are done.
What do you got for miles right now?
747.
All right, guys, this is where the car died. 750 miles. 748, 749. This is where the car died.
I have nothing to say. I don't know. What do you say, dude?
162 kilowatt hours.
Look, drive the Phoenix yourself, charge it up, and you take it 750 miles.